All right, guys, let's start at the beginning. You're getting the proper house construction tour now via Last Human's Home Life. We walk in, and I'm going to show you everything I did. This might be at least a 15-minute long video. So we walk in. We have the foyer, two-story foyer, right? First, I pulled up all the carpet in both these rooms, and I then, concrete patched all the big nail divots from all the carpet nail boards, and just, patched up, tried to seal the edges a little bit, things like that. So this is prep for wood, waiting for the wood to arrive. Then we get to here. I was gonna wood it, and we kind of changed our mind. Not really all price, but we kind of wanted, the whole floor is, hardened wood, and we wanted the down step here just to be a nice cozy little carpet room, just for the feel of it. So we decided to stick with carpet here. That's why for now, and this beep constantly goes off, I left the nail boards in and the padding just in case they say it's good enough. I had the carpet estimator here today to take all the measurements. Waiting to hear back on that. Then the kitchen was the one thing that was done before we moved in. So it's pretty nice. It isn't the most gigantic kitchen in the world, but it's nice. It's real nice. I never had, countertops this nice and stuff. And of course I have fridge ordered, washer, dryer in the other room, whatever. And this opens right here to that dining room that we just saw. I'm going to take off those flower things pretty damn quick. So I'm not going to touch this paint. Anyway, so let's say, see, it's all down. Then this is the TV room. Again, I was going to carpet this. And again, I changed it. I said, I'm going to floor it. So the whole downstairs will be hardwood, except for the front room. And I kind of peeled away all the nail strips and transition strips. So when I put wood here, I can put the nice blocker strip and just make it a seamless transition on both sides. Again, here I had to patch every nail hole and every divot that came up. That's my first round of patching here. I'm going to smooth it and do it again probably. And I'll show you the carpet that I've done all myself since in the last few days. This is all the carpet in the entire house and all the padding. The padding weighed even more than the carpets. It's super thick, heavy, dense foam or something. Trimming that bamboo bush right there that was in my driveway. Threw all that junk down there for now. I want to dig up that half stump. Like, I don't know if anybody knows bamboo. I don't know what this is, probably not bamboo. I want to cut it here, but I don't know if this is all one giant plant or if I can kind of hack it right down there away from the driveway and kind of leave it like that. That's something else I'm thinking. That's just a little bit in the wood. All the blinds, curtains, rods, everything is over there for now. All right, let's go, let's have a walk upstairs. I pulled about 2,000 nails out of all these floors on the upstairs and the stairs. There was just three generations of nails in here, all different colors from three different carpet jobs. So that in itself took a few days just to pull the nails up from upstairs. Let's go to the master, which isn't gigantic, but then I'll show you why it's good. So it's a decent sized master. I mean, it ain't tiny, but our other one might be a tiny bit bigger. But where the difference is the huge bathroom area we have transitioning into the actual restroom. Really nice sink area. Three big closets. This one's about 15 feet long. Then you have two mini closets. This is about 6 or 8 feet. This is about 4 or 5 feet. Three huge closets. Pretty sweet. Get rid of that disco lights at some point. All of these things are storage areas on each side. Not bad, not bad. Stripped off everything for the paint, as you can see, every little receptacle cover, all the blinds, ready for paint when I tape it off. But I haven't done the mudding yet, as we talked about. I actually have a paint guy coming to estimate the mudding for me. Just want to get an idea how much it is. This is not the worst room that I showed you the other day. There's just some cracks here and stuff that I'm just gonna have to chip away. But this isn't by any means the worst room. So I could probably do this room myself. All right, Let's go down the hallway here to the three bedrooms then. This is the office. Again, everything stripped, including the closet. Every staple taken up on the entire floor. Every once in a while, I find one that I missed, like right there. I think I couldn't actually reach, I couldn't reach that with any tools, so I gave up. All the closets cleaned out and ready, all the bolts tightened and all the shelves. We're gonna paint the closets too, of course. This was like just a light up here that had the stick-on cord cover, and of course, have to do mudding on that stuff. Rips everything off, it's so old. Let me turn down my music for a minute. I forgot. And there's the receptacles there. Then we swing around to Preston's room. We're gonna paint everything light gray, by the way. Same light he had. We ripped off the cord, the stick-on cord cover, and of course it sticks to the wallpaper, whatever. I think they painted over everything. It was a big mess. So prepping this, shelves are all solid, tightened all the bolts. Gonna just paint over that, same color. Everything ready. This one is chipping. See, all this chips off here. This all needs to be shored up. Another big closet. That's about it there. Last room, I think. This is Chelsea's room. This is the room that I showed you in a quick Instagram video once with the really bad, all this stuff here has to be mudded in. And I don't know if we go as far as to chip all this away. Probably not. This actually, I mean, maybe. I mean, I don't want to wreck it right now, but yeah, I got to chip away some of this stuff. It's just not ideal, you know? But hey, you know how much easier it is to do it now than do it later. And some of the wall stuff, people are saying a little mud will take care of that. No big deal. Rips in the wall here and there. Now you say, why do I have a mask? Well, I was peeling off some really loose popcorn and I found a little bit of black mold. Yeah, just a little bit. At this point, I'm not too worried about it. I got to investigate it a little more and I'll show you what it was. In the popcorn ceiling right above me. So it's really right there. And when I saw it, of course, I peeled way back around everything to see how bad it was. It looks like it's here. And those scrape marks, that's like the vacuum. So the good thing is it is very surfacey and it isn't real deep. And of course I'm gonna look upstairs in the attic above here, see what's going on too. But the inspection did not find any moisture areas or anything. I do believe this is old, but we'll see. So I'm gonna put on the mask and vacuum a little bit more just to clean it up than I am. Probably gonna do bleach, someone mentioned that. Bleach over it to just make sure it's inactive, stuff like that. The popcorn ceiling is going to be a big pain. I was not planning on touching it. Obviously, now I got a problem because I'm missing a bunch of ceiling here. I do not want to strip all this popcorn. There's no way. So I'm not sure. It isn't. I mean, I could leave it like this for a while. We can't do everything before we move in. But I am glad that I found it. Lucky I have a 5-horsepower vacuum. Guys, I took off the mask now to show you what is definitely the cause. So I'm happy with the answer to this. Let me get a light for you here with my iPhone. This is a dual zone AC place, which is pretty dang sweet. And obviously the AC is right here. It gets moist, as you know. And just gotta be careful of the moist dripping there. And of course that is where this came from, right under the water type area. Of course I'll check it, but it didn't look fresh. We'll have to see if it gets wet there still. We might have to do something about that. But that's a perfect explanation of why you have a little bit of mold right there, right where the AC might drip in the condenser stuff. All right, guys.